King Herod. They suddenly realize that he might have someone else who claims to be king. People like the countless families in Bethlehem who were suddenly fearing for their baby's lives as Herod began madly killing all the baby boys. People like Mary and Joseph who suddenly had to flee to Egypt to protect their newborn baby from this king. And people like you and me who forget. Other people's lives have changed, though, like the Jewish scribes in Jerusalem. How do you think they felt, these leaders of the Jewish church? How do they react when these pagan Easterners show up looking for their Messiah, for the Jews' Messiah? These Jewish scribes' plan was to keep all the religious power for themselves. They were the ones who had the answers. They were the ones who knew the scriptures better than anyone, or so they thought. And then these foreigners, these pagans, prance in there and claim to understand something about Jewish prophecy that even the Jewish scholars had missed. And how could they deny it? For there was the star. And the king of Judea, Herod the Great, his life was forever changed too. He was no Jew. He didn't care about the Messiah as a Jewish king or as a Jewish promised one. He was a pagan. His father was a man, his mother was an Arab. He was a cruel man. He was a wicked man. Especially to anyone who he felt might be a threat to his power, a threat to his throne. For instance, King Herod the Great had 10 wives. One of them he had killed, along with her 3 sons and a brother-in-law, among others, because he was afraid to lose his power, afraid to lose his kingship. So when these magi told him that the Messiah had been born, he was furious. For a Jewish king would be a Roman rival, and he might be more popular to the Jews than he himself was. So his plan, which was to kill anyone who might threaten his power, use whatever means necessary, was carried out in this case as well. So he lies to the magi and told them he wanted to worship this new baby too. Magi, whose lives also just been suddenly changed when this strange star appeared, and they set off on this crazy journey to another country, looking to give a baby really expensive gifts. Where is my heart back? When they found Jesus, they didn't tell the king. They snuck back to their own country another way. And Herod quickly realized he'd been tricked. Now Herod, maybe he didn't know quite how old his Messiah was. So he ordered that every male child under 2 years of age in Bethlehem be killed. And then Joseph and Mary's life took a change as well, as they had a high trailer for Egypt. Protect their newborn from the sword of the king's soldiers. And those soldiers were acting under the command of their bloodthirsty, power-hungry murderous king. So to recap, you see how messed up this story is. Everyone in this event has plans, plans that have suddenly been changed. And they all conflicted with each other. Herod the Great wanted power. The scribes in Jerusalem wanted respect. These pagan wise men wanted to worship God. Joseph and Mary wanted to protect their newborn Jesus. And God, well, God uses all of this. He chose this way to begin giving himself to the world. So God uses a false understanding of astronomy to lead these wise men to Jesus. Herod lies and says he wanted to go see, even worship the Messiah. And the wise men see this as a lie, and they deceitfully promise to do as Herod had said. All this to carry out God's will. Deception and lying and strange events. Because, you know, God will stop at nothing to bring his light to a dark world. For you and me, this whole thing is so comforting because nothing in this world before the return of Christ will ever be 100% accurate. Everything that we do, everything that we are involved in, we tainted, we'll be broken by sin. So if you wait until your bank account is full and you have a good place in your career to have a baby, had nothing to give us Jesus. I like Paul in Ephesians 3, it's our epistle reading today. He says, to me, though I am the very least of all the saints, this grace was given, to preach to the Gentiles the unsearchable riches of Christ, and to bring to light for everyone what is the plan of the mystery hidden for ages in God who created all things, so that through the church, the manifold wisdom of God might be now be made known to rulers and authorities in the heavenly places. See, God's wisdom surpasses ours. His understanding is so much greater than ours. His perspective is not bound by human sinfulness, human constraints. And he will stop at nothing to bring his light even into your life. I mean, when did God ever work in ways we might expect? Who would expect a God who would become human? Who would expect God to endure the sufferings and pain of the cross? Who would expect a God who would die for you? He stops at nothing to give himself to you. He even uses these pagan foreign wise men, or sickness, or death, and sinful pastors, and pain, and struggle, and joy, and water, and bread, and wine, and simple words spoken in a sermon and in the scriptures read to you. Anything else in all creation to reach you and me and all people. Some have thought the cards were stacked against Jesus, Mary and Joseph. At first there was no room for them in Bethlehem. King Herod the Great wanted to kill him. The Jewish scribes denied him. Joseph's family undoubtedly raised their eyebrows at Joseph for sticking by this unwed mother. The only people outside of the